Hi guys, and welcome to another Elementor video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, today we're going to create some hover effects using Elementor. You can do this with both the free version and the pro version. And let's see, this one on the right is sort of text to image on hover. And the one on the left obviously is image to text on hover. Really easy to do. We've got to write a little bit of CSS for this, but any CSS I write today, I'll put down below this video and you're welcome to use it. So let's get started. Let's go into my page here and we'll start down here. So I'm going to go to my grid and just get a little text editor module, drag it in there. There it is. Now I'm going to make this into two rows. I've actually got three rows here with one real small one in the middle, so I've got a separator between my two there if you want to make multiples. Okay, so let's add a new column. There's two, and if you want to do what I did above, we'll add another one. And this middle one, you can simply drag these in until it's where you want it. 48.8, let's see if we can't make this one the same. There we go. Okay, now the reason we're actually doing this and not depending on the spacing in the modules is because the image that we're looking at here is actually going to reside in the column, not the actual module itself. Okay, so let's style our little module here a little bit. First thing, let's put a little title in, kind of what I did up the top here, just a heading 2. And like any text module, you can link these and do what you can, what you want, just like any other WordPress module there. Okay, let's pop over to style there. I'm going to align it in the center. And I want to make it sort of square-ish. It doesn't have to be perfectly square. So let's add a little bit of padding. We'll go over to advanced. I'm going to uncheck the chain, because if you leave that checked, it'll do all four at once for you. I want to do top and bottom, left and right, kind of separately. So I'm going to put 100, top and bottom. Left and right, I'll put 30. Obviously, you do exactly what you want to do. Okay. Now, when I hover over, you can see this little blue line here. And it's slightly in from our column. The column's a dotted one on the left there, which means there's a little bit of padding there. And that's in the column itself. So we're going to go to the column now. And this little dark box is for the column. The little blue one with the pencil is for the module within the column. So let's go to the column. First thing I'm going to do is get rid of that padding right there. And that's in advanced. And let's try padding. I'm pretty sure it's padding and not margin. Let's go there. Yep, that did it. Now they're on top of each other there. Fantastic. Let's go over to the style. We're still in the column tab here. Background type. Well, I'm going to go for an image. It says slideshow, but if you just put one image in, it can't slide, so it'll just be an image background. And I guess I'll use that similar picture. Insert it in there. As you can see, it's already behind us. Can't read this text very well. So we've got our image in there. I'm quite happy with the way that's lying back there. If you want to see more of the image, just add a bit more padding and it'll sort of grow. But let's go into our little module here to the style. I'm going to make my text color white, purely so it stands out. And there it is right there. Okay, what do we want to happen? Well, when they haven't got their mouse over there, when there's no mouse on this, I don't want to see the text. And then when the mouse goes over it, I want the text to fade in. So we're going to need to write a little bit of CSS for that. And like I say, I'll put this down below. Don't bother copying it while I'm doing it, and you're welcome to use it. Now, I've actually got the pro version here, so I'm going to go to the advanced tab and down to custom CSS. And you can do it exactly the same way with the free version, except you'll have to do it in your theme customizer. If I go back to there, most themes have additional CSS box down here, and you can do it just as well in there. So what do I want to happen? Let's write this. First thing I need to do is give this module what they call a CSS class. So that's in the advanced. We're still on the advanced tab and under advanced here. Let's give it a class so we can target it. This is image to text, so I'm going to say IMT, image to text. Call yours what you want. It wants to be unique and it wants to be something you can remember as well. So we've given it the class of IMT. Now in the custom CSS, it's a class. We always have to write a dot, IMT, image to text, I called mine. Open and close some curly brackets. And in between, we'll put our CSS. Right, the first thing we want to do is make this disappear. So we'll use opacity for that, or see-throughness. So I'll say opacity, colon, 0. That should make it disappear. Yep, there it goes. Now just under here, the time that it takes when we hover over it to bring that back, like I did with this one, I've used quite a long one. I've used 1.5 seconds. You put in whatever you want. But for these hover effects, I think a fairly long one's quite good. But that's entirely up to you. So we're going to say transition dash duration colon and the time you want. I'm going to put 1.5 seconds. Great. Now to make it come back in, we've got to create a hover state. So let's copy what we've got here. Control C, drop down a couple and I'll paste it in below. Control V. Now just after the T of IMT, no gap, I'm going to put a colon, then no gap again, H-O-V-E-R, the word hover. Now we can create our hover state. So when we hover, we want it to be fully visible. And that will be opacity 1. You can make your opacity 0.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, various different gradients of visibility. 0 being invisible, 1 being fully visible. Now I don't need the transition duration because nothing's changed there, so we can delete that line and just tidy that up. Let's see if that's going to work. There we go. And as you can see, that's brought that in there. Okay, let's update and preview our changes. There's our image. When we hover over it, it's taking a second and a half to pop in our text. That's a nice little feature right there. People are mousing around your site, that happens. It's going to get their eyeballs on it. Now, to flip it around the other way, couldn't be easier. What I'll do is I'll go back in, I'll duplicate this module, and I'll drag one of them, doesn't matter which, over to this column. Now then, we're going to have to go in. Reason you can't see anything on this side now is because our text is white and our background's white. There it is actually there. But we need to go into our column and perhaps put another image in there. So let's go into our column and over to style. Here's our background again. We'll plump a little image in there. Again, I guess I'll use the same one as I used before. Okay, we've now got an image in there, and of course it's doing exactly the same. Before I go back into my module, I want to get rid of that padding right there. Again, that's advanced. 0. There we go. Fantastic. Let's get back in there. Okay, now we're going to give this a background. We're in our advanced tab. We're in the module itself, the text editor. Here's the background. I'm going to give it a simple color. And let's give it a white background. And as you can see, Now it's fading it. It's got a white background. We need to make that text dark and flip the effect around the other way. So go to style, text color. Let's make our text color dark again. There we go. And as you see no image behind there. All right, so what we need to do is flip it around the other way. And that for our custom CSS, we'll have to give it a separate ID. This is, we can't use the same ID because it'll affect the other one. I'm going to call this one text to image TTI. So we're giving it a class. We need to go down here to our custom CSS that we wrote before, change our class name, text to image TTI. Do exactly the same for the hover down below. Make sure you don't cut off that colon. And flip it around. We'll say opacity 1, fully visible at first, and it should be immediately visible. There we go. And we'll put this one to 0. And when we hover, there we go. Our little image will pop in. Again, let's update. And preview our changes. And there we have it. The only other thing I will mention is this. If you've got an image that doesn't let you see your writing too well, you can put a bit of an overlay in there, a darker background, which I've done with this one above. To do that, it's very simple. If we just go into the module itself, or the widget as they call it with Elementor, and we'll go to advanced background. I'm going to give it a black background, but I'm going to bring the opacity or see-throughness down. If I do that, you see it's black when I hover over it. If I take the opacity down to, I don't know, somewhere down, quite low, which makes it very see-through, just makes that image a little bit darker and you can read the text better. This image works quite well without it, but a lot of images you're going to need to do this so you can read the text. So let's leave that in there. There we go. And as I said, let's just update. I'm using the Pro, so I can put my custom CSS in this little box in the module itself, or the widget itself. If you don't have the Pro, you can do it just as easily by putting it in the additional CSS in your theme customizer. You'll find your theme customizer under appearance, and there'll be a customize of some sort there. And as far as I know, all WordPress sites have some form of additional CSS or custom CSS box, and you can write it in there. Just to prove the point, let's preview our changes up here so everything's working. And I'll take this away. This is the IMT, so it's this one. Control X. Now if I update and save that, as you can see, nothing's happening with our first one right here. Now if I go into our theme customizer, it's a good idea to give your things a title in here, so ...:**/, because if you write a lot of CSS in here, sometimes it's hard to find. If you put a title in, it'll be easier to find. So image hover, or whatever you want to call yours, simply paste that code in below it here. Let's publish it. Now if we go back to our page and I refresh, that should now disappear again. It should work again. And there we go, there's how to do it on the free version. So there's a couple of image to text hover effects, or text to image hover effects, depending on which one you like. I hope you found that useful and enjoyed it. If you have, please ring the bell, give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.